Okay, cool. All right, perfect. Thank you for your patience. I know that took a minute.
All right, you want to get another?
No, I'm good. I'm perfect. I just need to put my lip gloss on.
But who's going to see this?
Vamos a ver. Whoever needs to see it is going to see it. I just knew I wanted to be the first person to interview you because, I mean, especially once I played the game, I was like, damn, this is like fire. It took me forever to set up.
Can you see this both?
Okay, yeah. You can do it from that angle, too.
So you're recording two times?
Yeah, why not? Okay. Wait, but can I see you? I need you to be in that spot. That's why I told you not to move. Hold on. Oh, yeah, I can still see you. All right. Okay, great. So, hello. How are you doing today?
I'm good.
Good. Awesome. So, I'm here with, why don't you tell us your name?
Henry Woods. I'm the owner, founder, creator of Sneaker Legend, Inc. Mm-hmm.
And it's a pretty awesome
app. Yes. So it's a gaming app.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, it's a bomb gaming app that me and a lot of my coworkers have been on. And I want to talk to you today about Sneaker Legends and just about also your background and what in your background inspired you to make this app. So we'll start with the first question. How important for people who really like are not from Oakland, who are not from an urban community, tell us how important are sneakers for the average kid from a place like Oakland, California?
So, you know, growing up here, having sneakers going to school was like the ultimate kind of like eye catcher, right? So, in my generation, so I'm 35, right? Your shoes, it was like important to, you know, all your friends, because it's like everybody had shoes from East Bay, Nike.
Right,
all
East Bay. Stuff, right, you know? Right.
So, you know, for myself, I couldn't always be that kid, mm-hmm. right? Because my mom, she couldn't afford it.
Right. Right?
So I used to just look at the East Bay book and cut out, you know, sneakers and mm-hmm. like just like say one day I'm gonna have these on the sneakers.
Right, like a ghetto vision board.
Right, yeah.
I love that.
And so for me, it was like really important to create a gaming app where a kid or just a person like me can get some shoes that they can't afford or just can't spend the money on, right?
Right.
So, you know, to segue back when I was a kid, Jordans were much easier to get because
right.
it was like no box.
Right.
It wasn't people like wanting them as much as now.
Right.
And the
right.
resellers.
Right.
Like there was no resellers really mm-hmm. back when I was in high school.
Mm-hmm.
So it made it where you could order shoes and was not that hard,
mm-hmm.
right? So I feel like I missed that part of it because like now you got to stand in a line for 10 days. And,
yeah, it's ridiculous.
You know what I'm saying? So,
who has time
yeah.
for that?
But yeah, like that is the main thing that inspired me is just kind of my childhood, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to create a fun gaming app
mm-hmm.
to where everyone can enjoy it, not just African American or white people, everybody in China, London, anywhere, you know what I'm saying? So Africa, everybody.
Yeah.
So
also, so people who are playing the game even in other countries can win the.
So in December, it's going to be available internationally. So right now, it's only available in the United States.
Okay.
So,
So what was your push to make sure that your gaming app was not just on a domestic platform, but also an international platform?
I mean, because America's small, like a lot. So the United States has 339 million people, and it's 8 million people on the planet. So that'd show you America is a very small aspect of the entire globe.
Right. Yeah. And you think that children or youth or just people in other countries can relate to the sneaker culture that we have out here?
The sneaker culture is so widespread now. Mm-hmm. Like, it's in India, it's in China, it's in Africa. Like, everyone loves sneakers.
Right.
Like, from when me and you was growing up, it, like, everybody likes it, like, internationally, right? So, that's what broadens it out to where I can't just keep something of this magnitude just in the States. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
Okay, kudos for you. So you've kind of already hit on it, so I'm gonna just ask you this question, and I want you to really think about it, right? You kind of already talked about what inspired you to create the app, but I want you to convey for us the exact moment, like if you remember where you were and it just came to you and you were like, I gotta do this.
It came to me, you know, some years back, but I'm a creative person and I always have ideas, right? It took me a minute to push the button on this project. So, you know, funding, all that stuff, right? Like, timing, right? Like, timing is everything. So I felt like this was just a good time, because the industry is kind of, I don't want to say boring, but it's kind of stagnant.
Yeah.
To where it's the same thing.
It's very stagnant, and it's also not diversified in terms of the real stakeholders. It's a lot of consumers, but you're not coming in as a consumer. You're coming in as a producer.
Right.
So, like, what inspired you to, like, be a game changer?
I mean, I'm always trying to accomplish something that others might say I couldn't, or, you know, just kind of be an example for other kids, not just in Oakland, but just where you can inspire to be anything, to do anything. Because a lot of people ask me, do you have a tech background? And I tell them no. So that'll show you, you don't need a tech background to create something in tech.
Right.
You know, you just have to have the fortitude and the mindset to just kind of like put things together to where you can create something like your intent, right? And my gaming app, a lot of people would say, oh, like, he must have background in tech.
In tech, right.
And I don't, right? So, you know.
But you have worked with your hands, though.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I mean, which is the technical skill.
True.
So yeah. I feel like people who know how to work with their hands are kind of like what you were saying, you're a creative, you're more inclined to what you see in your mind, you're going to put it through your hands to make it come to life, or you're going to hire someone who can do it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So, and that's the main part, right? So, like I told you, like about funding, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, me being blessed with the positions that I've been blessed to have,
right,
it's given me the opportunity to, you know, be able to create this.
Right.
Right? So that's something that's, like, important. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? It's just kind of, because nobody has, you know, like, I'm kind of a one-man show, right?
Yes.
Like, I pay people on a contractor basis.
Okay.
Right? So all the ideas, everything is just coming from me. So, you know, that can be taxing mentally, but
yeah.
I feel like if I don't do it, who will? So.
Nobody. Exactly. Let me just make sure that everything's still rolling, because I'd hate to have to. Okay, great. Everything's going good. Mashallah. Okay, and make sure you're projecting, because I just want to make sure that it captures everything you're saying. Okay? So, can you talk us through the steps? Like, what were the steps that you took to getting the app created?
Oh, man. a lot of research, just kind of, because since I don't have a tech background, you kind of don't know how the industry works. You don't really know your first steps.
Right.
So really, I put up an ad on, what's it called? So it's a company where you put up ads to where you want people to help you fund. So a GoFundMe. So like I set up that.
Oh,
right?
That's smart.
Yeah. So in a company by the name of TechRup Innovations.
Oh, I heard of TechRup. Okay. Yeah.
So they hit me up. You know, Ben, he was like, hey, like, I want to hear your idea. Possibly we could work together and whatever. So, you know, from that point on, it's kind of like that's what, you know, I did. And, you know.
So you put up a campaign on GoFundMe.
Yeah.
And then TechRup Innovators.
Innovation.
My bad. TechRup Innovation. Yeah. Spotted you. They reached out. Mm-hmm. So they just happened to be perusing through GoFundMe?
Okay. Yeah, so. You know, they told me the price, right? They gave me a discount, which, you know, to create a gaming app is so expensive. You know what I'm saying? It
could be give us a ballpark? $100,000
Yeah, so.
Damn.
They worked with me a little bit, and, you know, I'm still working with them now, right? The gaming app's out. So just the small little things that the app might have bugs or whatever, they're the spearhead to keeping the app running.
Okay, so they weed out all the bugs. And how long did it take in terms of the testing process before you were able to premiere it? Yes.
So it took about a year.
Wow. You know,
it takes a long time to create a gaming app.
Mm-hmm.
It's so many steps to it. The average person don't understand. It takes a lot of work.
Mm-hmm.
And especially, I was working like a regular job too.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just a lot of just time. It's time consuming. So
you use your own money that you earn as a living to invest into your...
Yeah, so it was a dream, right?
So
I'm the type of person, you know, if I have a dream, right? It's kind of like I want that dream to come to reality, right? Because a dream could just be just a dream, but it's just a thought.
Right.
So I wanted to bring my dream, my thought to everyone else in the world. So I hope we could touch 8 billion people.
It's going to. I'm certain of it. So what was the biggest barrier for you in creating the app?
The biggest barrier for me was probably believing that I can do it, you know?
So not even the money.
So, no.
Yeah.
You know, because I'm the type of person, I do what I have to do when I have to. So it was the money too, but that was like a small part of it.
Right.
It's just really the belief in yourself.
Yeah.
Of just believing that you can create something that's great.
Right.
That can be great.
Right.
Right. So for me, that was the biggest thing, was just belief.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And I feel like so many people, we don't believe that we can create something that can be, you know, like touch the magnitudes of like people that we have never even seen.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I feel like that was the biggest challenge for me. It was just kind of forcing myself to like say, you can do this.
You can do it.
You know what I'm saying? So.
Were there times where you felt like giving up?
No.
You're like, nope.
No, not in this. Because, like I told you, once I start something, I'm a pretty good fan of church.
What sign are you?
So, Aries, Taurus.
Oh, that makes sense.
So.
Why don't you think more people from Oakland, who come from similar backgrounds, like you and I, like single moms and stuff like that, make more apps? Like, why do we seem to be more on the consumer end?
because we believe that if we don't have a background in something, we can't do it. Mm. So like, it's just like banking, right? Mm-hmm. Like, if you feel like, well, I need to go to school for banking,
mm-hmm.
or I can't be a banker.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, with anything, you can learn it. Mm-hmm. And it's experience.
Right.
So, I mean, to me, schooling is a very small part of, like, experience.
Right.
You don't get experience in school.
That is actually so true.
Right? So, you get experience by doing something. And I've always been the type of person, like how you said earlier, I use my hands, right?
Right.
Or, like, I use my mind to like, learn or experience stuff. Everything that I do, I don't really expect, like, much of it.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm like, well, if I accomplish it and if I put my all into something,
mm-hmm.
then it's like, if it can grow, you know, then it'll grow. But, yeah, that's really, like, the biggest reason that I feel like just not people in Oakland, but just people in general, like, they just say, well, I don't have experience in tech, and it's nothing like out here,
right?
That is kind of like a handbook of, like, if you want to design an app,
right?
You know what I'm saying? Google has a billion different topics on how to do something. You read 10 of them, you're confused.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? So it's no real, you know, pathway to kind of finding out. Like, you kind of just have to weed out things and just mm-hmm. kind of do it.
Okay.
You know, so.
Yeah. I love that. So I also noticed that your app promotes a lot of spatial recognition and pattern recognition. I've been playing it and I feel like it's really good for my brain. I actually live with a learning disability and I feel like it's been making my brain sharper and promoting neuroplasticity. When you were designing the app with, I guess, the team that you selected, did you think about that? Like, did you want it to be challenging? How did you go about designing the challenge levels? Because I noticed each level gets a little harder.
So, I mean, since the player wins shoes for free, right?
Right.
And the shoes could be worth up to $2,000 or whatever.
That's a lot.
Right, so we didn't just want a game where you play it and it's just super simple.
Mm-hmm.
We wanted something to where you're really achieving something.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a goal. Like,
right.
Every level, you're accomplishing a goal. So even though it's in the game, it's teaching your mind to actually accomplish goals,
mm-hmm.
right? And to finish. Because, like, yeah. A lot of people don't finish things, right? Like. A lot of people will say they'll do something or whatever, but they're not good finishers.
Yeah.
I feel like the most successful people are good finishers.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? Because it's like how you finish the game. It could be in the NBA, the NFL, right? Like, all the mm-hmm. great players, it's that last shot.
Wow.
Or it's that last amount of energy or whatever. It's like how you finish,
mm-hmm.
right? Because you could be up 25, 50 points, and I've seen teams lose by one. Right? So it's kind of like, I feel like that's the most important thing, is us finishing what we start with the game. We didn't really think about that aspect of it, but I told the team that I wanted a game where when you win the shoes,
right,
you really feel like I deserve to win these shoes.
Like,
you
I earned these.
Yeah. So that's what I thought about.
I really love the game. I'm not a game person at all. Like, I'm not. I've never been into video games. Like, that's my generation. But it's never gravitated towards me. But I love this game because I do like getting smarter. And Wallahi Azeem, I swear for God, excuse me, Lord, but you know I'm not using your name in vain. I really feel like this game is making my brain better. I've been promoting it not with just people my age, but with the youth,
yeah.
the babies,
yeah.
like, you know how children are always asking their parents for a pair of Jordans or a new pair of sneakers. I feel like if parents make their children do this game, it incentivizes It incentivizes both things. It incentivizes learning, and it incentivizes, like, working hard for something. And I've also been telling people my parents' age, like, y'all need to get on this app, Protect Your Brain, because I really feel like it can help prevent dementia and stuff like that. Like, I swear, I really think it's a really...
Because it keeps your brain active.
Yeah.
Because you're matching pairs of, like, sneakers, right? So it's like those fibers are, like, steady, you know, firing.
Yeah, they're steady firing. So, and it sounds simple, because, like, when you first explained it to me, it sounds so simple, but it's actually not. I mean, some people...
It's not.
It's not. Yeah, it's good. It's a really good challenge. Okay, so my last question for you is, what do you ultimately want to see come out of this app?
I just want it to be as successful as all the other games that's out there on the platforms. I feel like this game is nothing like it.
Right. There's nothing like it.
That's been designed like it. And I don't know any other game that you actually win something in real life.
I don't know. You're like, your heart is so generous, because I feel like so many apps are kind of predatory, and they just want to, like, sell our information, get us to buy things, but you're, like, giving stuff away. And I remember I was like, why are you doing that? And
yeah, I mean, like, I feel like it's important, because, like I said, the more users, you know, the more giving back, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, to get some shoes that you desire that you can't afford, or you just can't buy, that's priceless. Like, if there was a game like this when I was in school, yeah, I would have played that game. I would have been crazy, right? So, and it's a monthly basis. Like,
right.
Like, it's not like it's like a once a year thing. Like, you're winning, you have the chance to win shoes every single month, right? So, I mean, to me, you can't beat it, right? Like, for the month of December, I'm doing the top three players, right? So, the first player is going to win the Legendary shoe.
Uh-huh.
But since it's Christmas time, the second and the third player is going to win, like, some Air Force Ones.
Oh, so the top three? I thought it was just the top one.
Well, since it's Christmas time, then the top three, yeah.
That's so,
so
sweet. I love that. Your huge billboard ad on the A80, it's fly. Mm-hmm. Who made that?
Montclair Photo.
I went Paul, there for my sister's Paul. Passport
so,
picture.
So like a big shout out to
Paul.
Paul.
Okay,
he
Mark.
Really helped me, like, uh-huh. make this, because creating a billboard is not easy.
Yeah.
No, like, it's like different bleed sizes, it's different, like, you have to make it where they can blow it up to that size.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, if you look at that up close, like a billboard, it's pixelated, it's like,
right.
you can't even tell what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so it took a lot of work to get that done, but shout out to Paul.
Shout out to Paul and Montclair Photo. I was driving and I freaked out and I'm like, honest to God, it looks like it's on silk. It looks so smooth. And I was like, I was trying to hurry up and video it because I thought it was going to change, because I thought it was digital. Because, I mean, it just looks so clear. It's really nice. And I like just you as a man of color investing in yourself and being a role model for what it takes to, like, count on yourself.
Yeah. And a big shout out to Tom too from the billboard company.
Mm-hmm.
He really worked with me. You know, he believes in this too. So a big shout out to Tom.
Is Tom the one who designed the?
No, Tom is the person from the billboard company.
Okay.
So Brian from look it up really quick. So it's a So Brian, he has his own company for like the designing stuff, right? So he was really good at creating the billboard on how it is. So, but Outfront Media, Tom works for him, and then Brian, his company is called. Because they really helped me out, man. So
and just finding all the right people. Right.
And that's one of the hardest things to like do, you know, is finding the right people, because it is tedious, man. So you know. Right around the corner too. It's like it's not that far.
Oh, I was gonna also ask, like, how can people follow Sneaker Legends on social media?
So you can go to Sneaker Legend 2023, right? I have a website, it's www.sneakerlegend.net, right?
Okay.
So that's a good way to find Sneaker Legend, you know, so.
Is there an Instagram? Do people follow it on Instagram too?
So that's the Instagram. So the handle is Sneaker Legend 2023.
Okay, so Sneaker Legend 2023.
Yep. And that's a good way to like find Sneaker Legends. So
it's Sneaker Legend or Sneaker Legends?
Sneaker Legends. Without the S.
Without the S, okay.
So again, shout out to Brian. He has
tasteful.
So I have a clothing line that's coming out.
That's amazing.
So it's gonna be called something, you know.
Okay. You have to keep it on the wrap right now. Why don't you tell us the shoes you're wearing?
Well, you say they're fancy, so go ahead.
Givenchy's.
Okay.
They're nice.
Just check the app out, play it, right? Like, even if you don't want to win shoes, right, still play it. I mean, like, it's fun. Just where the game is now, mm-hmm. It's so much more that I'm going to bring to life in this game. So,
wow. Okay.
This is not it. So, yeah.
I mean, it's already amazing, though.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Absolutely. So, everyone, just stay tuned. Follow Henry Woods and Sneaker Legends 2023. It's going to be a new season
December 1st. So every month. Every month.
Oh, wow. Thank God. So if you're like low in the rankings like me right now, don't be discouraged.
You still have a chance.
Yeah. Thank you for your time.
I really appreciate it. You have a good one.
You're so funny. That was really good. You're a natural.
I'm not.
Yes, you are.